Winter sports in Philadelphia are complete. The NHL has announced today NHL season for 2021 will return, and it is all set. Today we're going to talk about what the NHL had to say. Let's get this started. That is right. Welcome everyone to my channel. I'm your boy at Barcelona Philly, the United of all things sports and culture here in the beautiful city of Philadelphia. Before we move forward, ladies and gentlemen, do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Barcelona grow in this crazy ass city. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we here in Philadelphia have been super excited for the start of Sixer season. The way the Eagle season has been going, we have been waiting for December 23rd, but we've all forgotten that the Philadelphia Flyers are the other winter sport, and we weren't sure whether or not they would actually return or not. We all know how the NHL is. We've seen two lockouts in the last 20 years with this league here. So it was a good possibility that the NHL could say in 2021, hey, we're not gonna have a season. And that really was a realistic possibility in my eyes, but I'm excited. The NHL has decided we will indeed have a 2021 NHL season, and some of the fine print is some good things, some good and some bad as well. But of course, let's dive into some of the important parts of the return of the NHL. And of course, we have an important Flyers tidbit here to talk about. So this video is gonna be a little bit quicker, but we gotta talk about this because hockey's back. Hockey is back. Let's get it, guys. So the NHL is eyeing a January 13th start, and this season will last 56 games in total. So obviously, it'll be a shortened season. We talked about this with the NBA, how they cut the season down a little bit as well, beginning in December, ending in March. So I think the same thing is going to happen here with the NHL as they cut down their season, almost 30 games. You know, the important part is here, of course, is the safety of the players, which I really hope that the NHL keeps that in mind. I really thought that the NHL, when it came to the bubble, did a fantastic job. They really did a great job of maintaining the COVID virus. It wasn't Canada, and we all know Canada is handling the coronavirus a lot better than they are here in America. But you know, dividing the Eastern and the Western Conference into Toronto, Edmonton, that worked very well. I don't think the NHL had any cases, to be honest with you, so that worked really well. So now the key is here is how do you maintain the coronavirus with the potential of playing in all these markets. The NHL is planning on having these teams playing in their own markets, and like we have seen in the NFL, even in the MLS, who've done a great job as well with coronavirus, and the MLB, they haven't done a good job with the coronavirus, but they also were playing in their own markets during this pandemic, and we've seen that there could be hiccups. We've seen teams being affected more than others with the coronavirus, and those are the risks you're going to take without a bubble. So if the NHL is planning to do this season without a bubble, you're going to run into those issues, and I'm curious to see how the NHL will handle some of those circumstances with coronavirus and positive cases. You know, it's one thing in the MLS and in the NFL when, you know, teams are playing one game a week. In the MLS, you play two at most a week. But when you're talking about Major League Baseball, the NBA, the NHL, teams are playing multiple games in a week. So one cancellation or one postponement can mess up a whole schedule. So that is something that we definitely have to keep an eye out here. Again, the NHL, Gary Bettman, always just, they don't know how to act. They don't. Like I've talked about, two lockouts in the last 20 years. This process of trying to figure out when the season was going to start shouldn't have taken this long. It's crazy how the NBA, where there's more money on the line in the NBA than there is in the NHL, and they were able to figure it out. Boom, December 23rd start time. Boom, we're going to play in these markets here. And boom, we're going to find a way to maintain these COVID cases. And the NHL just could not. It is what it is. I don't care. All I really care about is this right here. As long as I get to see my Fly Guys on the ice, that's all I really care about. But NHL, get your crap together. Get your crap together. Also, another tidbit here, the NHL will in fact actually do a realignment of the divisions for the season, just to make sure. I think they're taking this from the MLS. What you saw in the MLS this season was the MLS teams played a lot of the clubs around their area. So, for example, the Philadelphia Union played the Red Bull a lot. They played the New England Revolution for like 100 times, which is freaking annoying. But they played Montreal, Inter Miami, but just teams in their coast. And I think the NHL is trying to do something similar. They're just trying to allow these teams to play with the other teams that are close enough to them. So the next season, this is the proposal yet too. This isn't official, but what the NHL is looking at is dividing the NHL into four divisions. It looks like the Eastern Conference, the Central Conference, the Western Conference, and the Canadian Conference. This way, you keep these teams close enough together. There's not a lot of travel. You're able to keep your team contained in somewhat of a bubble. And I really think this is going to work well. But in the Eastern Conference, you got Boston, Buffalo, Jersey, New York Islanders, and the Rangers. Us, Pittsburgh, and Washington. That is good news because there was huge rumors that Pittsburgh and Philly could be separated. And you do not want to go into an NHL season without Philly playing Pittsburgh. Come on, NHL. You don't want to miss out on that. The Central Division here, we have Carolina, Columbus, Detroit, Chicago, Florida, Minnesota, Nashville, and Tampa. The Western Conference, you got Anaheim, Arizona, Colorado, Dallas, LA, Kings, San Jose, St. Louis, and the Vegas Golden Knights. And of course, your Canadian Conference will include all the Canadian teams, Calgary Flames, Edmonton Oilers, Montreal Canadiens, Ottawa Senators, Toronto Maple Leafs, Vancouver Whitecaps, Vancouver Canucks, and the Winnipeg Jets. So those are the division proposals there. I hope that is actually what's going to happen. That Eastern Conference, I already love. You know, you get to play all the rivals that we really have, both New York teams, Pittsburgh, DC, and Boston. I love it. And you play those teams throughout the season, I'm going to absolutely love that. So that is what the NHL has to propose. As far as fans in the stands go, still not sure. From my understanding, the NBA is planning to have fans in the stands. Maybe the NHL decides to go with that logic as well. The MLS did allow fans in the stands in most markets. I was actually in a game during the pandemic and I felt pretty safe, but that is an outdoor event. So it's different when you're inside. I did hear some teams are thinking about playing games outside. That's crazy. This is in the Winter Classic. Imagine a team playing outside for a full 56-game regular season. That would be crazy to think about. Think about the Flyers playing in Citizens Bank Park. It would be pretty crazy to think about, but it would be really tough to see. If it's an NHL team in a baseball market and the baseball field is obtainable during the NHL season, then why not? Then definitely go ahead and do it. But I have a lot of question marks with the NHL season. I wonder if this could really work here, especially in these playing in each other's markets. But at the end of the day, again, I'm excited because I got Flyers hockey coming back, and I want the Flyers back with the Sixers. The Flyers, after last season, left a sour taste in their mouth. The way we had the season going, we finally found our goalkeeper. Goaltender. I don't want to piss off the hockey purists here. We really thought that they could possibly make a championship run, but they lost to the underdog team in the New York Islanders. I don't even think we can call them underdogs anymore, but I'm ready for the season. I'm definitely ready for the season. Let's move on to the big news with the Flyers yesterday. They have actually re-signed Philip Myers to a 3-year deal. He was a restricted free agent, and this is a big move. You talk about that young core and with our defensive pairings. Philip Myers had a huge role last season, and this is a guy who didn't even start with the Flyers in the beginning of the season. He was down in Lehigh Valley, worked his way up. He has been continuously improving. Became a starter, became a regular, and now he is the future of the defense of the Philadelphia Flyers. And now with Matt Niskanen's retirement, his role will increase, and I'm going to be so excited to see what he can do. Big move here for Philip Myers. The defensive pairings, look, we all obviously have to replace Niskanen, which is going to be tough to do, but we it looks like we are going to keep Shane Goss fair, and I hope other youngsters can move up and improve, and hopefully Sam Moore can come back. Please, 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 please. That's all I got for you guys today. Let's continue the conversations in the comments below. Let me know what your thoughts are on the return of the NHL. Let me know what your thoughts were on the Philippe Myers signing as well. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this here to help your favorite Parcero grow. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I'm your boy at Parcero Philly, and I'm telling you guys, it is fly or die. Let's go, baby.